Where's Katie?
What you need is an emergency kit, a bag that's easy to get to, easy to reach, if there is a volcanic eruption.
In an emergency kit, you'll need a torch. When the ash clouds turn the sky black, you won't be able to see. The torch will help you see the way to your concrete bunker. You also need a whistle to let people know where you are when you're trapped.
What many people don't understand is volcanic ash isn't ordinary ash. It's abrasive, it's destructive, and it's rock. When a rock combines with the moisture in your lungs, it forms a cement-type mixture. So you ultimately drown in cement.
So you should also pack a mask.
Also, because it is so destructive, if it does get in your eyes, it can and probably will blind you. This is why you should also have goggles in your emergency kit.
You also need water for at least 2 days in your emergency kit, as the ash can contaminate water supplies, and also you need water if you are trapped.
If there is an eruption, you will hear a siren that sounds like this. If you hear this siren and have time, go directly to your concrete bunker. If you do not have time, seal all doors and windows and grab your emergency kit. Aerial photographs pointing to the crater note any changes on the surface of the volcano. You should have an up-to-date evacuation route planned out. This will help you get out safely and fast.
Ash is very heavy and can collapse roofs. Slope roofs help the ash slide off and not settle. They're usually made out of smooth metal.
Plastic coverings can be put on roofs to stop the corrosion by the ash.
Concrete bunkers are built as emergency shelters from volcanic bombs and heavy ash fall.
Some rock walls are built to divert lava from towns and villages. Helicopters and aeroplanes drop water onto the lava to cool it and to make it slower.
Military bombing will bomb areas to divert the lava away from towns and villages.
Follow this advice so you don't end up like Katie or Chloe.